Good morning, gang. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Today marks the 116th year from the tragic 1906 San Francisco earthquake. And today, at about 4:38 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, there was a 2.6 earthquake near Gilroy, California, along the San Andreas fault zone. 19 people said they felt this earthquake. And it was felt as far east as Los Banos and as far south as Salinas, California. There's been 3 earthquakes in this location in the last 24 hours. Here's the magnitude 2.6, and there was a 1.6 down along the Sargent Fault close to Hollister. Close to this location last year, there was a magnitude 4.2. That was January 17th of 2021. This too is not far from the 1989 6.9 earthquake, which came to be known as the Loma Prieta earthquake. And then offshore here, in 1926, there was 2 earthquakes within an hour of each other, a magnitude 6.1 and a 6.3. It is my opinion that the earthquake occurred along the Monterey Canyon fault zone. Many geologists believe the earthquake occurred along the San Gregorio, I'm all tongue-tied, San Gregorio fault. But the Monterey Canyon fault zone is about 300 miles long, and this is one of the deepest canyons there along the west coast. The walls of the canyon are about 1 mile deep. And as you know, most fault lines or most rivers will follow along fault zones. And you can see how the water flows in from Moss Landing. Most scientists also believe that if there was a large earthquake along the Monterey Canyon and it created a tsunami, it would be only a localized tsunami. It is a huge misconception that many people believe that these smaller earthquakes would relieve the pressure to prevent a larger earthquake, and that is not the case. In fact, it would take 32 magnitude 5s, or 1,000 magnitude 4s, or 32,000 magnitude 3 earthquakes to equal the energy produced by 1 magnitude 6 earthquake event. The 1906 earthquake, what was not destroyed by the earthquake itself was definitely destroyed by the fires that followed. USGS has an image of what was left of the city after the earthquake, and you can see the fires. This is an aerial view taken 5 weeks after the earthquake. This building here on the left is the Fairmont Hotel. There has been 3 earthquakes in the San Andreas fault zone within the last 24 hours. We got the 2.6, which was shallow, only 1.8 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. A 1.6 near Hollister, and then late last night, a 1.4 also near Hollister. This red line drawn out is the San Andreas fault zone. It's actually quite wide. But anyways, over here we got Gilroy, and then this is the 1.6 down there by Hollister along the Sargent Fault Zone. And then we got the San Andreas Fault Zone. These are actually extensions of the San Andreas Fault Zone. USGS gave this earthquake an intensity level of 4, which means it was felt by many indoors. Outdoors, well, by a few. And if people were sleeping, it may have woken them up. Dishes, windows, doors were rattling, and parked automobiles would have been rocking noticeably. One person did say they felt the 1.6, but did you feel any of these earthquakes, the 2.6 that happened early this morning? If so, put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for following me. If you're not subscribed, please hit the bell and subscribe. Hopefully you'll get notifications when I do a new video. Thank you for watching. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.